Hello, welcome to our service for the Two Valleys Mission Community for this week, the 14th of March, the fourth Sunday of Lent, and Mothering Sunday. So our service reflects Mothering Sunday this week. And also we're carrying on looking at one of the themes from our county's refreshed vision. And this week, the topic of caring deeply, caring deeply. And Bishop Emma has prepared a sermon for us on this topic. I'm relating it to Mothering Sunday as well, so we'll welcome Bishop Emma to preach for us this morning. So let's be still for a moment or two as we gather and prepare our thoughts. Lord, be with us in this time of gathering, at whatever time of day or whatever day of week it may be that we're watching this service. Help us to connect with you, to renew and refresh our discipleship, to be equipped for today and the days ahead. So we commit this time and each other into your hands. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen. The Lord be with you and also with you. Praise God who loves us. Praise God who cares. Blessed are you, God of compassion and mercy. To you be praise and glory forever. In the darkness of our sin, your light breaks forth like the dawn, and your healing springs up for deliverance. As we rejoice in the gift of your saving help, sustain us with your bountiful spirit, and open our lips to sing your praise. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Blessed be God forever. We're now going to light five different candles reflecting different aspects of motherhood and also how God looks out for us. And each time there is a response which you may want to join in with, which is, Holy God, we praise and thank you. Holy God, we praise and thank you. Holy God, we light this candle in recognition of the great care and love you have for each one of us. Holy God, we praise and thank you. Holy God, we light this candle in thanksgiving for all mothers, for all they do or once did, for all they give or once gave, and for all they mean and will always mean. Holy God, we praise and thank you. Holy God, we light this candle for all families throughout the world. Holy God, we praise and thank you. Holy God, we light this candle for the family of the Church, here and everywhere. Holy God, we praise and thank you. Holy God, we light this candle for all who nurture and encourage others. Holy God, we praise and thank you.
Thank you.
Let us come to confess our sins. As we prepare to encounter Jesus in his word, let us call to mind our sin and ask for God's mercy and forgiveness. In the same way that loving parents are tender to their children, the Lord is tender to those that fear him. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Like a mother hen, God gathers us to himself and protects us from harm. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. The one who gave us life deserves our love, willing obedience and respect. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. May God, who loved the world so much that he sent his Son to be our Saviour, forgive you your sins and make you holy to serve him in the world, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. The Collect for this week. God of compassion, whose Son Jesus Christ, the child of Mary, shared the life of a home in Nazareth, and on the cross drew the whole human family to himself, strengthen us in our daily living, that in joy and in sorrow we may know the power of your presence to bind together and to heal. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Praise God who loves us. Praise God who cares. The first reading is taken from Paul's second letter to the Corinthians, chapter 1, verses 3 to 7. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and the God of all consolation, who consoles us all in our affliction, so that we may be able to console those who are in any affliction with the consolation with which we ourselves are consoled by God. For just as the sufferings of Christ are abundant for us, so also our consolation is abundant through Christ. If we are being afflicted, it is for your consolation and salvation. If we are being consoled, it is for your consolation, which you experience when you patiently endure the same sufferings that we are also suffering. Our hope for you is unshaken, for we know that as you share in our sufferings, so also you share in our consolation. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. A song of St. Anselm. If we all say the antiphon together, and if you would like to join in with the even numbered verses, I will lead us in the odd numbered verses and say the even numbered verses with you. Gather your little ones to you, O God, as a hen gathers her brood to protect them. Jesus, like a mother, you gather your people to you. You are gentle with us as a mother with her children. Often you weep over our sins and our pride. Tenderly you draw us from hatred and judgment. You comfort us in sorrow and bind up our wounds. In sickness you nurse us, and with pure milk you feed us. Jesus, by your dying we are born to new life. By your anguish and labour we come forth in joy. Despair turns to hope through your sweet goodness. Through your gentleness we find comfort in fear. Your warmth gives life to the dead. Your touch makes sinners righteous. Lord Jesus, in your mercy heal us. In your love and tenderness, remake us. In your compassion, bring grace and forgiveness. For the beauty of heaven, may your love prepare us. Gather your little ones to you, O God, as a hen gathers her brood to protect them.
A reading from John chapter 19, verses 25 to 27. Meanwhile, standing near the cross of Jesus were his mother and his mother's sister Mary, the wife of Cleopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple whom he loved standing beside her, he said to his mother, "Woman, here is your son." Then he said to the disciple, "Here is your mother." And from that hour the disciple took her into his own home. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Today is Mothering Sunday, a day when we celebrate all of those who have offered us care and compassion throughout our lives, whether that's our actual mothers or people who have given us mothering, the gift of love and care. Mothering Sunday is a source of joy and celebration as we give thanks for mothers everywhere. But it's also one of pain, as we recognise that family life is seldom easy, and that there are people everywhere who feel the pain of loss of mothering in so many ways. Those who have been unable to have children, those whose mothers have died, those who have difficult relationships with their mothers, and those who are separated from loved ones for any reason, which today, of course, is most of us. Although we rightly now use this day to celebrate the contribution of mothers everywhere, Mothering Sunday isn't really about mothers at all in its origins. Originally, it was a time where people celebrated and gave thanks for the Mother Church, and it was the Sunday on which people returned to their home churches where they'd been baptised. So that's why, of course, this Mothering Sunday takes on an added poignancy today, when many of us may not be going into our local church buildings due to the restrictions around the COVID pandemic. We're finding other ways of worshipping and praying and being church together, much of it online and from our homes. But it's strange, isn't it? It feels unusual and peculiar at best, even painful. Meeting together with our fellow worshippers is something that those of us who do it often, or even just occasionally, value so much. And for the time being, many of us aren't able to gather in the way that we would like to. Now, you'll be forgiven for thinking that the gospel reading that we've just heard is a slightly odd one to have for Mothering Sunday. The crucifixion, it's what's set for today as the reading in the lectionary, but it does seem at first glance to be a bit gloomy, a bit depressing. Surely that reading is for Good Friday. We could cope with it then. Why today can't we have something a little more promising with spring and flowers and sunshine and hope? Well, perhaps the reason that reading is set for this day is that it describes really accurately the bittersweet reality of love and loss that is most people's experience of mothering in one way or another, and indeed of family life in general. Mary, the mother of Jesus, alongside his mother's sister, his friend Mary Magdalene, and his closest friend John. Together they look on as Jesus suffers and dies on the cross. And even as Jesus hung there on the cross in his love, caring and dying for the sins of the whole world, he was concerned to make sure that after his death, his mother would have someone to care for and someone to care for her. And so he commended Mary and John to each other. "Woman, here is your son. John, here is your mother." And there, underneath the cross, a new family is born. A family not based on blood ties or nuclear family relationships, but on mutual devotion to the one on the cross above them, under the shadow of its suffering. Jesus' death on the cross makes possible new relationships. It breaks down barriers between humankind and God, and between us all. That's what the cross of Christ shows us. The cross is the very opposite of social distancing. The cross shows us that God has come very near to us in Jesus Christ. The theme of the refreshed vision that we think about today is the call to care deeply. These two small words carry so much meaning. Of course, we are called to care deeply for those we love and even for ourselves, which is one of the things that many of us find the most difficult. We're to care deeply for our brothers and sisters in the church, fellow Christians, if you like. And we're certainly going to need a whole lot of pastoral care as we emerge from the challenges of lockdown that have resulted in so much pain and suffering for so many. We're also called to care deeply for the local communities in which God has set us, including the worldwide family of humanity of which we are all a part. That is a whole lot of caring, and it could be easy to feel overwhelmed. But at the heart of this simple story of Jesus' mother Mary and Jesus' friend John at the cross and Jesus' instruction to them to care for each other when he is gone is the simple message that as a church we're to mother people, to welcome all with gentle compassion, to provide hospitality, to listen, to care, and to never give up on caring, to weep with those who weep, to mourn with those who mourn, to join in with others who are likewise offering care in our local communities. So as a church, we are called to be a place where people can come and be at home. Our other reading today is from 2 Corinthians chapter 1, where Paul sets all this in the context of worship. Praise be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of compassion and the God of all comfort, who comforts us in all our troubles, so that we can comfort those in any trouble with the comfort we receive from God. That's 2 Corinthians chapter 1, 3-5. When we offer comfort, another way of saying care deeply for each other, we do so because God has first cared for us and will be with us in our caring, giving us what we need to be able to care and comfort. We are not alone. And so on this most unusual of Mothering Sundays, our prayer is that under the shadow of suffering, a new community will be born. A community of people the length and breadth of Cumbria, who even while scattered, gather together in spirit, under the shadow of the cross, to care deeply and to discover together the new kind of family that Jesus calls us to be. Let's pray. Loving God, you are one God, and you bring together what is scattered and mend what is broken. Unite us with the scattered peoples of the earth, that we may be one family of your children. Bind up all our wounds and heal us in spirit, that we may be renewed as disciples of Jesus Christ, our Master and Saviour. Amen.
Praise God who loves us. Praise God who cares. Let us declare together what we believe. Words taken from the Te Deum. You, Christ, are the King of glory, the eternal Son of the Father. When you took our flesh to set us free, you humbly chose the Virgin's womb. You overcame the sting of death and opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers. You are seated at God's right hand in glory. We believe that you will come and be our judge. Come then, Lord, and help your people, bought with the price of your own blood. and bring us with your saints to glory everlasting.
Let us pray. Loving Heavenly Father, we come to you today as your children, with grateful hearts for all the love you have shown to us throughout our lives. On this Mothering Sunday, we thank you for our own mothers, for stepmothers, foster mothers, grandmothers and godmothers who have shown their love over the years. We thank you that Jesus was born into an earthly family, and so we pray for all families. We think of our own families. We pray for families separated by the COVID restrictions, the lonely and isolated, broken or homeless families, and those needing financial help or support from food banks. We bring to mind all who are ill or awaiting treatment or surgery, that they may know your presence and feel your peace. Help us never to forget that every COVID statistic is a loved one lost and a family grieving. And so we bring to you all those who are bereaved or remembering loved ones. Today, we think of Jim Lupton, Thomas Gledow, June Sadler, Hazel Myers, Mary Hallis, John Taylor, Peter Ratliff, Bill Cannon, Bob Bradley, Fortune Stanley, and Andrew Wolf King, whose anniversaries fall this week. Lord, in your mercy. We ask your blessing on children as they return to school, renewing friendships, learning to work together again, and for secondary pupils, wearing masks and testing for COVID. We thank you for the dedication of teachers throughout the pandemic and pray for them as they care for the children. In the past year, we have been especially grateful to all those in the medical profession and in our communities who have truly cared deeply. Let us bring to mind those who have cared for us personally and ask, Lord, that you will bless them. We bring to you our church family. We pray for our bishops and all who lead us in the two valleys, and pray that we will care deeply for those within our churches and the wider community. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for our Queen at a time of isolation and sadness, and we pray that Prince Philip will soon be well enough to return to her side. We pray for all members of the royal family suffering so much sadness at this time. As the government and scientists work together to find the best way through the pandemic, we pray that you will guide their decisions and that guidelines will be followed for the good of all. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. As we rejoice in the signs of spring, let us look forward to next week's theme and tread gently in your creation. We pray for our farmers and ask that you will grant dry weather for lambing and a warm spring for the lambs to grow strong in the sunshine. And now a blessing. May the sun bring us new energy by day. May the moon safely restore us by night. May the rain wash away our worries and the breeze blow new strength into our being. May we walk gently through the world and know its beauty all the days of our lives. Amen. And now we join together in the prayer Jesus taught us, saying, Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and for ever. Amen.
On this Mothering Sunday, we once again give thanks for all mothers. Praise God who loves us, praise God who cares. For the care of mothers, thanks be to God. For their patience when tested, thanks be to God. For their love when tired, thanks be to God. For their hope when despairing, thanks be to God. For their service without limit, thanks be to God. So we come to God's blessing. Praise God who loves us, praise God who cares. Living Lord, as we offer to you our common life, refresh our vision that we may know your will and seek to follow you in all your ways. May we follow daily as your disciples. Care deeply for one another in community. Speak boldly your gospel words of love and tread gently as faithful stewards of your goodness. We ask this in the power of your name as creator, redeemer and sustainer of our lives, today and forever. Amen. Jesus, Lord of time, hold us in your eternity. Jesus, image of God, travel with us the life of faith. Jesus, friend of sinners, heal the brokenness of our world. Jesus, Lord of tomorrow, draw us into your future. Amen.
Well,
Well, thank you again for joining with us. We have one more week, next Sunday the 21st, of an online service of this nature. And then the following week, Palm Sunday on the 28th of March, some of our churches will be back worshipping in their buildings. And so the recording, the online service, will need to take a different form. But we hope to produce something or to direct you to something each week online as we slowly return to our church buildings and are able to worship in them as well. Commend to you our Thursday gatherings as ever for on Zoom as we continue to explore in a little bit more depth each of these four themes. So this Thursday, either in the morning at 10:30 or in the evening at 7:30, we'll be looking at caring deeply. I hope you have a good week and wish you God's blessing.